Dear students, Namaste and welcome back to a new mathematics session. In the previous session, we have discussed how to draw different angles by using ruler and compasses. Hope it was clear for you all. In today's session, we shall discuss construction problems from exercise 11.2. Let's move on to the topic. Exercise 11.2, first question. Construct a triangle ABC in which BC is equal to 7 cm, angle B is equal to 75 degree and AB plus AC is equal to 13 cm. We are asked to construct a triangle ABC. Measurement of one side is given to you, BC 7 cm, and one angle is given, angle B is equal to 75 degree, and the relation between two sides AB plus AC is 13 cm. So let's see how this figure is drawn. First of all, we have to draw a line segment BC of length 7 cm. Then angle B must be 75 degree. So we know how to draw 75 degree by using ruler and compasses. So take a point P and taking BP as a radius, draw an arc. And with P as center, by using the same radius, cut the arc and make the point as Q. And draw another arc with Q as center and label it as R. And now with R and Q as centers, we are drawing two arcs and the intersection point, we have to mark it as S and join BS, and now the 90 degree angle is formed. And this point we have to mark it as T. We need 75 degree angle, means up to here is 60, and this 60, 90, if you bisect, you will get another 15. So 60 plus 15 is 75. So next step is we have to bisect T and Q. So arc TQ we have to bisect. For that, with T as center, draw one arc. With Q as center, by using the same radius, draw another arc. And point of intersection, we can mark it as U. This point of intersection, so you can use any alphabet, it's not a problem. This B, C and A, it should not change. The remaining points, you can use any alphabet, it's not a problem. Now join BU, then take this one as a ray BX. Then AB plus AC is given to us 13 cm. Next you have to be very, very careful. AB plus AC is given to us 13 cm. So by taking your compass, take 13 cm from your ruler. From your scale, you have to take 13 cm in the compass and fix at B. Draw an arc and it will be little bit lengthy enough, so you have to adjust while drawing. So mark the point as D. So BD we have taken as 13 cm, AB plus AC 13 cm. That 13 cm we will take in the compass, fix at B, draw the arc and mark the point as D. Then join C to D, join C and D. Then next we have to bisect, or we have to draw the perpendicular bisector of this CD. So perpendicular bisector of this CD we have to draw. For that, take more than half of length of CD, fix at C, draw one arc, fix at D, draw one more arc, both the arcs will be meeting at a particular point. The same construction you can do on another side of CD also. Using the same radius, fix at C, draw one arc and fix at D, draw another arc, both arcs will meet at this point. So perpendicular bisector of CD, that is what we are going to construct. So these two point of intersections we can mark it as M and N, then join MN. And this MN is intersecting BD at A. So that point, the intersection point of this perpendicular bisector and the ray will be A. That is our the third point of triangle ABC. First two points we have taken B and C, and the third point is A that we have got here. So now join AC. Now here triangle ABC is constructed. So ABC is the required triangle. Next we'll construct the original diagram. First of all, draw a line segment BC of length 7 cm by using the ruler. By taking your compass and at any convenient radius with B as center, draw an arc.
label the point P with P as center, and also by using the same radius draw an arc and label it as Q, and with Q as center by using the same radius draw one more arc and label it as R, and by using any convenient radius with R as center draw an arc. By using the same radius with Q as center, draw one more arc and mark the point of intersection of the two arcs as S. By using your ruler, join the points B and S. Now at B, a 90 degree angle is constructed, and label the point T. Now we have to bisect the space between T and Q. By taking any convenient radius with T as center, draw an arc. By using the same radius with Q as center, draw one more arc and mark the point of intersection of the two arcs as U. By using your ruler, join the points B and U and extend it and label it as ray BX. Now, by using your ruler and compass, take 13 cm in your compass and fix your compass at B. Draw an arc on the ray BX and mark the point D. By using your ruler, join the points C and D. Now we have to bisect the length CD. For that, take more than half of length of CD by using your compass. Fix your compass at C, draw one arc above and one arc below the line CD, and by using the same radius, fix the compass at D. Draw two arcs which intersects the previous arcs and mark the point of intersections as M and N. By using your ruler, join the points M and N. So the line MN is meeting at BD at the point A. So now the three vertices A, B and C are formed. By using your ruler, join the points A and C. Now ABC is the required triangle.
Next, we shall write the construction procedure. As I have mentioned in the previous classes, construction procedure, this is only the sample. You must write it as your own. First step, draw a line segment of BC 7 cm. This is the construction we have completed in the previous slide. So BC is 7 cm we have drawn. Next, draw angle B is equal to 75 degree and draw the ray BX. At B, we have drawn 75 degree by using ruler and compasses, and we have drawn the ray BX. Ray means you have to extend at 1 inch. Then next one, take a compass and measure AB plus AC is equal to 13 cm. By using your compass and ruler, you have to measure 13 cm in the compass. Then with B as center, draw an arc at the point and the point B, D. With B as center, we have drawn an arc on BX and mark the point as D. And join D to C. DC we have joined. Next, we have drawn the perpendicular bisector of this CD. While drawing the perpendicular bisector of CD, we have got the line segment MN, and MN is meeting at the point A. That is what mentioned here. Join AC. So A to C we have joined, and ABC is the required triangle. So ABC we have got here. So this is the steps of construction. Next, we shall discuss question number 2. Construct a triangle ABC in which BC is equal to 8 cm, angle B is equal to 45 degree and AB minus AC is 3.5 cm. Here, one side BC is given to us 8 cm. One angle, angle B is given 45 degree and a relation between AB and AC, that is AB minus AC is 3.5 cm. Let's see how it is drawn. First of all, draw a line segment BC of length 8 cm. At angle B, as before, we have to fix at angle B and construct 45 degree by using ruler and compasses. Take a point P and with the BP as a radius, draw an arc. With the P as center, draw the arc Q, and with the Q as center and also by using the same radius, draw the arc R, and with R and Q as radii, we have to use two arcs and the point of intersection we have to mark it as S and join BS. So now 90 degree angle is formed. This is quite familiar for us. And this point we have to mark it as T. Actually we need 45 degree angle, means we have to bisect TP. The arc TP, if you bisect, we will get 45 degree because total angle here is 90 degree. 90 degree half is 45. So fix your compass at T and taking more than half of length of TP, draw an arc and fix at P, cut the arc and mark the point of intersection as U and join BU and extend, and you have to mark a point X here, that means ray BX we have drawn, and here this angle is now 45 degree. Now AB minus AC is 3.5 cm. So first, next what you have to do is you have to use your compass and take 3.5 cm and fix at B and draw an arc and mark the point as D. As before, join these two, that is CD we have to join. And the next step, we know that in the previous question also, the after joining we have bisected that line. The same thing here also we have to do, CD we have to bisect. For that, use your compass, take more than half of length of CD, fix the compass at C, draw one arc up and down of CD, and by using the same radius, fix the compass at D, cut the previous arcs and join the point of intersection of two arcs. So here we have drawn two arcs by fixing the compass at C and D. By using the same radius, we have to draw two arcs on the another side of CD. So these two point of intersections we can mark it as E and F. This is only a rough diagram, no scale of construction is used here. So it is only a sample figure without measurements, just for explaining the procedure I am drawing. So just join E and F. And just to produce it, because E and F joining time, it should meet on the line which is passing through B. So you must extend it up to here, then only you will get the meeting point. So that meeting point you have to mark it as our third point of triangle, that is A, third vertex of the triangle, that is A. So as before, join A to C. So all three vertices we have got, ABC we have got. So the required triangle ABC is formed.
Now let's see the original construction. By using a ruler, draw a line segment BC of length 8 cm. By taking any convenient radius with B as center, draw an arc. Label the point P and by using the same radius with P as center, draw an arc. Label the intersection of two arcs as Q and with Q as center and also by using the same radius, draw one more arc and label the intersection of two arcs as R. Now we have to bisect R and Q. For that, by taking any convenient radius, fix the compass at R, draw an arc. By using the same radius, fix the compass at Q, draw one more arc, and the point of intersection of two arcs we can label it as S. By using your ruler, join the points B and S. Now at B, 90 degree angle is formed and label the point T. Now we need 45 degree. For that we have to bisect the space between T and P. For that take more than half of length of TP. With P as center, draw an arc. By using the same radius, with T as center, cut the previous arc and mark the point of intersection of the two arcs as U. By using your ruler, join the points B and U. And produce BU and label it as ray BX. Now take 3.5 cm in the compass. With B as center, draw an arc on the ray BX. And mark the point D. By using your ruler, join the points C and D. Now we have to bisect, we have to draw the perpendicular bisector of the line CD. For that, take more than half of the length of CD. Draw one arc by keeping your compass at C, above and below of CD. And by using the same radius, fix the compass at Q. Cut the previous arcs. Mark the point of intersection of two arcs. E and F are labeled. And by using your ruler, join the points E and F. And you have to produce the line EF till it meets the ray BX, and mark the point of intersection of two lines as A. Now the three vertices A, B and C is formed. Join the points A and C. Now the required triangle ABC is constructed.
Next, we shall discuss the construction procedure. This is a diagram we have drawn, and first one is draw a line segment of base BC 8 cm. Simply you can draw a line segment BC of 8 cm. That is also not a problem. Then draw angle B is equal to 45 degree and draw the ray BX. At angle B, by using ruler and compasses, we have constructed 45 degree angle and we have drawn the ray BX. Next is using compass measure AB minus AC is equal to 3.5. It is given the condition for us AB minus AC 3.5 cm we have taken in the compass. With the B as center and draw an arc at the point BD on the ray BX. With the B as center we have drawn the point, we have drawn an arc and marked the point D on ray BX. Next is join DC. So we have marked the point D here, D to our another vertex, given vertex is C. So we have joined. And the next is draw the perpendicular bisector of CD and the point of intersection is taken as A. So we have drawn the perpendicular bisector of CD, that is EF, and we have extended this line and we have got the point of intersection as A. Now join AC, ABEC is the required triangle. After joining AC, we will get the triangle ABC. So this is the steps of construction. Move on to question number 3. Construct a triangle PQR in which QR is equal to 6 cm, angle Q is equal to 60 degree and PR minus PQ is equal to 2 cm. We are asked to draw a triangle PQR. QR is given to us 6 cm, angle Q is 60 degree and PR minus PQ is 2 cm. The relation between PR and PQ is given to us. This question is somewhat different from the previous question, so the construction procedure you must watch very carefully. First of all, we are going to draw QR 6 cm and take a point M and by taking QM as radius with Q as center, draw an arc. We are going to draw 60 degree angle. So with Q as center and QM as radius, we are drawing an arc. And by using the same radius with M as radius, you have to cut it. Label the point as N. So now this 60 degree first arc cutting time, we will get 60 degree measurement. Then just not like the previous one, here something different way of drawing is there. Next we are drawing a line which comes, one part is above QR and another part is below QR. So it goes like this. So this is the difference between the previous question and this question. So we have drawn a line, means we can extend on both the directions. Previously we have drawn a ray, and just make it as QX. And PR minus PQ is 2 cm for us. Since PR minus PQ is 2 cm, here we have to draw an arc by taking 2 cm in the compass. With Q as center, we have to draw the arc below QR and label the point as S. And next step is as before, the point what we have drawn and the second vertex we have to join, that is SR we have to join. Once again, first you have to make a 60 degree angle, and after that we have to draw a line, means one portion should go above QR and another portion should go below QR, and I will label it as QX. And with the 2 cm, by taking 2 cm in the compass, with the Q as center, draw an arc, label it as S, that is S comes below QR, and join SR. And now you have to draw the perpendicular bisector of SR. It is quite clear for you how to draw the perpendicular bisector. Take more than half of length of SR, draw one arc up and another arc down, and by using the same radius with R as radius, cut the arcs which you have drawn previously. So it comes like this, and label the point as O and C. As I mentioned before, you can use any alphabet, it's not a problem. Only P, Q and R are mandatory, you cannot change. Join these two points O and C, and it will meet at this point P here on OX, and join PR. Now triangle PQR is formed. So PQR is the required triangle.
Now let's construct the original diagram. Draw a line segment of length 6 cm and label it as QR. At Q, we have to construct an angle of 60 degree. For that, with Q as center, by taking any convenient radius, draw an arc. Mark the point M, and by using the same radius and also with M as center, draw an arc and label it as N. Now the 60 degree angle is formed. Join the points Q and N by using your ruler. And we have to produce Q1 downwards, that means below QR. Take 2 cm in the compass. With Q as center, draw an arc that is below QR and label the point S. Join the points S and R. Now we have to bisect SR. For that, take more than half of length of SR. With S as center, draw two arcs. One is above SR and another one is below SR. By using the same radius with R as center, draw two arcs which intersects the previous arcs. label the point of intersection of two arcs as O and C. By using your ruler, join the points O and C. And mark the point P. Now the three vertices of the triangle P, Q and R are formed. By using your ruler, join the points P and R. PQR is our required triangle.
Next, we shall discuss the construction procedure. This is a diagram we have drawn in the previous slide. First one, draw a line segment QR of length 6 cm. Then at Q, we have to draw 60 degree angle by using the ruler and compasses. And take a compass and measure PR minus PQ is equal to 2 cm. This is the given condition. By using the compass, we have to measure this length. And this is a very important step. With Q as center and draw an arc below QR. With the Q as center, we have to draw an arc below QR and label the point as S on the ray OX, on this line OX. Here join RS. Next is we have to join R and S. Now draw the perpendicular bisector of the line RS and the intersection point is taken as P. So perpendicular bisector of RS it is taken, we have drawn, that is OC, and the intersection point is P. Next is join PR and PR is joined. After joining PR, PQR we have got, and PQR is the required triangle. Dear students, today we have discussed first three questions from exercise 11.2, and with those questions we have completed chapter number 11, constructions. I request all the students to construct all these questions separately in a sheet of paper, and while doing, if you have any doubt, please note it and keep. We will discuss it during the discussion session. Thank you for watching.